Thank you. Let's go. The fifth and final day of the fifth special session of the 22nd Congress will now come to order. May we all share a moment of silent prayer. Okay, roll call, the clerk.
Senator Arritos.
Yes.
Senator Christian.
Yes.
Senator Figuier.
Yes.
Senator Colon.
Yes.
Floor Leader Harper. Senator Conman.
Aye.
Vice Speaker Moses.
Am I.
Senator Nett. Senator Pollock?
No.
Senator Perman? Senator Romulo?
Am I?
Senator Orozumal?
I am around.
Senator Wally?
Yes.
Speaker Simina?
Yes.
Mr. Speaker, all 14 members are present.
Okay, we do have a quorum to transact business. Next item is reading of the journal for Leader Harper.
Thank you, Speaker. Move to dispense with the reading of the journal.
Second.
Okay, it's been moved and seconded that we dispense with the reading of the journal. Next item, presidential communications, Chief Clerk.
George Rizes, please.
George Rizes, subject to call of the chair. Oh, Chief Clerk, you ready? We can go back now?
Yes, Mr. Speaker, thank you.
Congress is back in session. We're on the presidential communication. Clarify on the record, Chief Clerk.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Kindly note that the correct order is the one with the item 5, presidential communications, three of them. And they are numbers 22-300 to number 22-302.
Okay, assign those, Chief Clerk. Next item.
Item number 6, CFSM Supreme Court communications, none, Mr. Speaker.
Okay, next item, continue.
Item number 7, member communications, none also. Item 8, departmental communications, none, Mr. Speaker. Item number 9, HNCR governmental authority communications, none. Item 10, state communications, none, Mr. Speaker. Item 11, state Supreme Court communications, none also, Mr. Speaker. Item number 12, municipal or town communications, none. Item number 13, foreign government communications, none, Mr. Speaker. And item number 14, miscellaneous communications, none also, Mr. Speaker.
Okay, we're now on our order of the day. Item 15, standing committee reports. Chief Clerk.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Under the said item, we have one report, and that is standing committee report number 22-38 on congressional bill number 22-147 from your committee on Jay and Go for adoption.
Chairman Romano.
Move for adoption.
Second.
Has been moved and seconded that Congress adopt standing committee report number 22-38. What is it about, Chief Clerk? Report.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. This is on congressional bill number 22-147 to amend section 205 of title 52 of the code of the Federated States of Micronesia annotated as amended for the purpose of increasing the pay salary schedule of FSM national government employees and for other purposes.
Okay, there you have it. Discussion on the report. Any discussion?
Either.
None. Chairman Norsimo.
Yeah, thank you very much, Mr. Speaker. As I asked, I believe it was yesterday when this thing first hit the floor, but was deferred. Is this applicable to all public service system employees of the national government?
Chairman Romolo?
Yes, I believe so.
So those that got increases fiscal year, last July, would also get an increase if this thing becomes law.
Chairman Roosevelt, I mean, Chairman Romano.
Yes, the increase was all for all the national government employees, so as this salary increase.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Thank you, Chairman. May I just ask one follow up?
Ask as many follow-ups. Get it off your chest.
The increase here would be equivalent to how much in terms of the increase? Is it 5% increase, 10% increase, 15% increase? And is it across the board?
Chairman Romano?
Thank you very much, Chairman Rosamal. If you recall, during the committee, the hearing, we have asked the relevant departments and staff to testify on the amount that can be affordable. And if you recall, the representative from the Department of Finance budget, he indicated that the 100% increase would not be supported. He would not entertain because we may not have. But he told us that 50%, if it's going up 50% salary increase, we can afford.
Okay, so there you have it. We can afford. We can. Yes.
We can afford. Yeah, it's not, in my case, it's not a question of affordability. May I know in total with this, whatever the percentage is,
being proposed here. What is in term of dollars? How much per year?
I thought you're not worried about affordability. So what are you asking?
No, I am worried.
Let's say affordability,
we talk about not only the salary, we also talk about priority needs of this nation.
4 million.
Okay, Chairman Rollo, respond.
Well, in terms of amount, let's say if an employee is receiving $150, so that 50% will be $75 added to the 150,
okay,
and times 26 payroll in a fiscal year.
Mr. Speaker.
Yes. Wait. Vice Chairman Palik, you want to also help?
Yeah, thank you. Mr. Speaker. Right. Thank you, Chairman Rusamol. I think the other way to answer that is not enough to cover cost of inflation as of today. So regardless of amount, I think that it's an insignificant amount to address inflation cost today. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
So it's worth it, Chairman.
I got lost on the, my, so 4 million is the total cost of the salary increase as proposed by this measure.
Yes. Yes.
And currently we're scratching the bottom of our bank account because of so many things, including the COVID, correct?
That's correct. I guess we've appropriated close to 20 million for public projects.
So, okay, dollar 150 salary for national government employees currently is zero. No one is getting $150 per pay per year. Okay, we're talking more about 300. So a $50 increase to a typing clerk, you know, those that log in, log out, let's say of $300, that's an increase of $150, correct? If my mathematics is correct.
Okay, if you want to cross-examine Chairman Romolo, yes, that's...
If I want to do what, Speaker?
If you want to cross-examine... those are leading questions.
Chairman, Speaker, don't try to create World War III here.
Yeah.
Congress is back in session. Chairman Romulo, you have the floor.
Thank you very much, Mr. Speaker, and members who have expressed their concerns regarding this said bill. I will try my best to summarize my response.
Your point of information.
State your point, Chairman.
Yeah, are we talking about a bill or a committee report?
The report. We're talking about the report.
And let's confine our discussion to the report.
Yes, sorry.
Sure, that's what Chairman Romulo is trying to do, explain the report.
Okay. Yes, sir. Again, yeah, I will try my best to summarize my response to the questions were asked during recess on the report that is before us. Those concerns have raised and responses from the relevant department's staff who were attending the hearing. First, on the losing of state employees. It has also brought up that even the national government have lose many of its employees because of not affording what they're taking home with their salary. There are employees of the national government who have to take off work for 1 or 2 days to go fishing and farming to supplement what they are taking home with their salaries. Because the cost of living now compared to what they're taking home, it's cannot sustain the livelihood of their families. We do understand that we cannot dictate the state salaries. But we're hoping that this will also help the state, the policymakers, to also reevaluate and see ways and means to also help the state employees. I would not say that they will have to increase it just like the national employees, but they will find ways to increase their salaries in accordance to what their local revenue or their operations. Do not entertain these salaries, we will still see or experiencing losing staffs of our national government, because they have to find where they can earn enough to supplement, to support their family. As indicated in the report and by the witnesses, yes, every year we appropriate a certain amount for operation each before the beginning of its fiscal year. And yet during its fiscal year, there is still money, revenue available available from finance for us to work with. So they have factored in that with this increase, as they stated, a 50% increase would still be affordable. And they have seen it from before the pandemic hits. During this pandemic, we have seen a slightly decrease in our local economy, but yet they see that we will still earn enough revenue to accommodate the increase. So with all your concerns, I hope we can also factor in the need for our people and the cost of living today, when we make decisions in passing this report or amending this report if we have to fit what we think that is right. But I'm asking that we need to see how we can support this, the pass this report and support this bill, which would benefit our people. And at the end, the money that we will be giving our employees with through increasing their salaries will also generate it within our local economy. They're not gonna take it out and spend it elsewhere outside our economy. It will be generated within our economy through taxes, through deductions. It will not go anywhere. It's just a matter of, the way I look at it, it's just a matter of taking from one pocket, putting it into another pocket in a different way. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Chairman. Thank you, Chairman Romulo, for your explanations. Yes, continue discussion. Who's that?
Mr. Speaker.
Vice Speaker, yes. You have to.
Thank you. Yeah, it's always a good thing to try and look on how to increase and take care of your employees' salaries. But the point raised by Chairman Gulen with regards to those proposed amendments, and let's say we pass this and then we give the 50% increase to the employees, which I think is a good thing. However, if for some reason the revenue distribution proposed amendment to the Constitution with regards to fishing fees passes, what recourse do we have if we don't generate enough revenue anymore because of that amendment being passed? That's my question.
Okay. Chairman Romulo, you care to? I don't think it was considered during your hearing.
Yes. I would not have any response because this report was done before these proposed amendments. So if it was a bit after the proposed amendment, we would have also raised so the appropriate staff and relevant department and agencies can look into and see how we would. Thank you.
I will just respond this way. That is the prerogative of this Congress. It will be the Congress that will decide what to do, whether make a further adjustment or not. But even if we do the, even if that one proposed constitutional amendment pass, I suspect that there will still be more than sufficient revenue for the national government. And it's just a matter of prioritizing. So, but for now, I know we do have, as pointed out in the tables, we have the revenue to, if we have to pass this,
Speaker, may I?
Yes, continue, Vice Speaker, then.
Thank you, Chairman. Mr. Speaker. Yeah, but we don't know what those priorities are yet. Because when you cut 80 million in half, that's 40 million. And it would be nice to know if that amendment is gonna pass or not, and then move on something like this. Because I would like to support it, but there's that uncertainty. And yes, it is a prerogative of Congress. But if we do that, I'm wondering the recourse. We don't know what the recourse will be. That's my concern.
Okay, yes, well, Dagan, it's noted. But for us to base a decision that will have real impact simply tomorrow on something that is still uncertain, which is whether it will pass or not. I'm referring to the proposed constitutional amendment. That is something, a different issue that we'll have to tackle it when it comes up. But for now, this is what we have. The hearing, as pointed out by Chairman Romulo, is that the employees of this national government have, you know, ran away from their positions because of the insufficient salaries that they're getting and wages that they're getting.
Speaker. So,
and the inflation is something that requires this Congress to come up with something on how to assist the livelihood of our citizen employees or employees of the national government. Okay, who's that? Chairman Kunin.
It's okay. I'll talk when it's off record.
I'll give it to Chairman Fikir then. Chairman Fikir.
Speaker, it seems that there's need to be a lot of assessment or studies done on this because of the proposed amendment to the Constitution and also so much uncertainties. Even when we speak about the fishing revenue, we don't know how whether it's going to increase, stay the same, or decrease. So I suggest that we defer action on this to the next session, perhaps in September, and the committee to continue making assessments on how this is going to impact the economy and the revenue of the nation.
Okay, Chairman Romulo, you want to respond to this? You're the one taking the lead.
Yes. Well, I don't have problem in delaying it, but if we keep delaying it, awaiting this proposed amendment to see how it would affect. So I would think that it's going to keep delaying the passage of this proposed bill. Because then, but if we go back and do an assessment again, it's going to be pretty much the same, except to factor in if this proposed amendment passes. Then that's just gonna be the difference that it will make. But to go back and ask the relevant departments and agencies to do a reassess, it's gonna come back the same.
So Speaker,
I hope we can move forward with this
bigger
report.
Rodriguez.
Speaker.
is back in session. We're still on the Standing Committee Report 22-38. Any further discussion?
Speaker.
Question.
Who's that?
Yeah, Speaker.
Alec? Okay.
Yeah, thank you very much, Speaker.
Last word before we vote.
Yeah, thank you very much, Speaker. Just a general rule, the 80-20 rule, that 80% of the work is done by only 20% of the people. You know, Chairman Berman raised an issue earlier on, and I totally agree that performance should be emphasized. And government anywhere, government is one of those agencies where I think we're pretty loose on making sure that people are doing their work and get paid for what they deserve. On the other end, I understand the situation nowadays with respect to cost of living, inflation. By standard, I think our employees, national government employees, are on the in the region lower scale. And if we just look at cost of living, inflation, adjusted for inflation, no brainer, I will support adjustment in salary to help our employees. But at the same time, as a congressman, you know, I walk around, go around the states, and one of the key questions people ask me is, what can you do to help improve our salaries at the state level? And discussion we have, Chairman Willie and I have with the state leadership on what we can jointly do to help improve the salaries of our state employees, private sector, because 80% of the activities of this nation is in the states. We are addressing a small percentage of people at the national government. I don't want to sweat the small stuff, I support it. But my concern is, what are we doing with the rest of the nation at the state level? Earlier on, some senators asked, well, why are you, is Kosrae state delegation giving state subsidy to the state government? These are some of the ways we're trying to help the state. So I just want to state for the record that, you know, we need to continue to seek ways to help the states. I know that it's pretty simple to say that, well, that's not our responsibility. We should only focus on the national government employees. But how do I respond to those people in the villages at the state level, any of our states that are suffering? Because I think the disparity now and the effect of inflation is far greater in those states. National government by standard, compare national government employee salary to the states, they're far higher. So I just want to state for the record, again, for me, I continue to give subsidy to the state government, and I don't mind having them use those funds to help their salary adjustments. As a matter of fact, one of the discussions Chairman Willie and I had with the state leadership is exactly that, what can the National Congress or you two as delegate Congress do to help us with this one major problem we have at the state level, and that's state government employees' salaries. I'm ready to support this bill. You know, I don't have any problem with this, the report and subsequently the bill. But my concern is really, what are we doing to the rest of the nation? Thank you very much, Speaker.
Thank you, Vice Chairman Pelik. As a starter, keep increasing your subsidy to your state.
Thank you.
Governments. Yeah. Okay. So, if no further discussion, let's vote. Those in favor of the adoption of Standing Committee Report 22-38, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, nay.
Aye.
The Standing Committee Report 22-38 is adopted by Congress. Okay, next report, Chief Clerk.
Mr. Speaker, we have an awaiting list number 22-26. For more standing committee reports awaiting the 24 hours requirement.
Speaker.
Yes, who's that?
Speaker.
Berman.
Berman. Thank you, Speaker. If I'm not out of order, like us to move down to the resolution calendar.
Second.
Okay, it has been moved and seconded that Congress moved on to the resolution calendar. Without objection, so be it. We are now on the resolution calendar, item 20. Okay, We're now on Chairman Berman, you have the floor.
Yeah, thank you, Speaker. Speaker, I would like to venture a motion to withdraw and place the following resolutions under the resolution calendar. It's 22-131, 134, 135, 136, 137, 138, and 140. I so move.
Second.
It has been moved and seconded that resolutions number 22-131, 134, 135, 136, 137, 138, and 140 be withdrawn from committees and placed on the resolution calendar for action. Those in favor of that motion say aye.
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 Aye. Motion carried. Those enumerated resolutions are now withdrawn from committees and placed on the resolution calendar for action. Okay, short recess. Allow Chief Kirk to link them. Chief Kirk, short recess. Congress is back in session. We are now on the resolution calendar. First resolution, Jipper.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Under the resolution calendar now is Congressional Resolution number 22-131 for adoption. CR number 22-131 is a resolution approving and accepting a grant in the amount of STR 12,700,000 from the World Bank for the purpose of funding the FSM Skills and Employability Enhancement Project, including all the terms and conditions of the assistance.
Move to recommit the resolution to the committee.
Second. Moved and seconded that resolution number 131 be recommitted to committee. Those in favor say aye.
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 Motion carried. Resolution number 22-131 is recommitted to committee. Next resolution, Chief Clerk.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
What a privilege.
State your point.
My time is up, please. Can I be excused now?
Well, yes, you may be excused. You may miss out on some important votes, but I think your health comes first. So, yes, you may be excused.
The delegation rep?
Yes.
Your health is more important. I wish you the best. Okay.
All right.
Yeah. Okay. So read the resolution.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Under the resolution calendar now is Congressional Resolution number 22-134 for adoption. CR number 22-134 is a resolution expressing the sincere condolences and sadness of the 22nd Congress of the Federated States of Micronesia to the family of Dr. Rivino Mauricio at his passing on June 26, 2022.
Okay.
Motion to adopt.
Berman, yes.
Second.
It has been moved and seconded that Congress adopt resolution number 22-134. Discussion. Any discussion? Sure.
Mr. Speaker.
Okay, Chairman Ursmal.
Yeah, thank you very much, Mr. Speaker. I wish to include my personal sympathies and condolences to the family of this late doctor, a giant in his own profession, a very dedicated and friendly and understanding human being, one that doesn't complain, did never complain about the works and about salaries. He was director and secretary of department and office. And even with the salary not increase, he wasn't raising any concern and complaints about it. Very dedicated to works of developing the FSM customs and traditions, and was instrumental in setting up short videos on the places of importance in each of the four states. I was personally made a friendship with the individual during our travels together, especially one to, I think it was Fiji, and he was very helpful. No, it wasn't Fiji, maybe Samoa, where they show local shows. And then he personally, as director, or secretary, he personally accompanied me and my family to Nanmatol and did very good job in explaining, sharing the history of Nanmatol, including when my children and grandchildren were very, very happy when he explained all of those to us. So. I have a personal attachment to the individual, and I wish to convey my sincere condolences and sympathies to the family. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
Thank you, Chairman Rusimol. Well said. And I think we all join you through your statements and also through this resolution in extending to especially our colleague, Senator Berman, for the loss of family. Okay, any other discussion? If none, without objection, discussion is closed. Let's vote. Those in favor of the adoption of resolution number 22-134, say aye.
Opposed? Aye.
Motion carried. Resolution 22-134 is adopted by Congress. Next resolution, Chief Kirk.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Under the resolution calendar now is Congressional Resolution number 22-135 for adoption. CR number 22-135 is a resolution requesting the President to allocate any remaining grant funding for COVID-19 relief at the national government level to the four states to assist in our nation's efforts to transition to a safe post-pandemic open border.
Chairman, Berman.
Thank you. Motion to adopt the said resolution.
Second.
Been moved and seconded that resolution number 22-135 be adopted. Discussion. Any discussion? If none, without objection, discussion is closed. Let's vote. Those in favor of the adoption of resolution 22-135 say aye.
Aye.
Opposed nay. Motion carried. Resolution 22-135 is adopted by Congress. Next resolution.
The next resolution currently under the bill calendar is Congressional Resolution number 22-136 for adoption. CR number 22-136 is a resolution approving and accepting a grant in the amount of 400 million yen from the government of Japan to provide funding for the purchase of four small patrol boats for the government of the Federated States of Micronesia, including all the terms and conditions of the assistance.
Chairman, Arono.
Move for adoption.
Any second? Yeah. It has been moved and seconded that Congress adopt resolution number 22-136. Okay, discussion, short recess. We're now on that resolution, 136. Any further discussion? If none, without objection, discussion is closed. Those in favor of the adoption of resolution 22-136, say aye.
Aye.
Motion carried. Resolution number 22-136 is adopted by Congress. Next, resolution declared.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. The next resolution currently under the resolution calendar is Congressional Resolution number 22-137 for adoption. CR number 22-137 is a resolution approving and accepting a grant in the amount of 300 million yen from the government of Japan to provide funding for the purchase of diesel fuel for patrol boats for the government of the Federated States of Micronesia, including all the terms and conditions of the assistance.
Okay, Chairman, Romano.
Move for passage.
Okay, any second?
Okay.
Has been moved and seconded that Congress adopt resolution number 22-137. Discussion. Any discussion?
Speaker.
None. Chairman Urusima.
Thank you very much, Mr. Speaker, Wesley W. Simina. Will the money grant here, can it be used to fuel humanitarian help with the other patrol boats?
Okay, anybody? Anybody? Short recess.
Speaker, I...
Is back in session. We were on resolution 22-137. Is there any motion to adopt? You already made? Oh, yes. So discussion.
Question.
Okay. Question has been called for without objection. Discussion is closed. Let's vote those in favor of the adoption of resolution number 22-137. Say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, nay. Motion carried. Resolution 22-137 is adopted by Congress. Next, resolution to prepare.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. The next resolution under the resolution calendar is Congressional Resolution Number 22-138 for adoption. CR Number 22-138 is a resolution to approve and accept a grant in the amount of $144,220 from the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services, Health Resources and Services Administration to support and fund the Universal Newborn Hearing Screening and Intervention Program for the budget period from April 1st, 2022 to March 31st, 2023, including all the terms and conditions of the assistance.
Chairman Perman.
Move to adopt the said resolution.
Second.
It's been moved and seconded that resolution number 22-138 be adopted. Any discussion? Any discussion? If none, without objection, discussion is closed. Let's vote. Those in favor of the adoption of resolution number 22-138, say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Motion carried. Resolution 138 is adopted by Congress. Next resolution, dear clerk.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. The next resolution currently under the resolution calendar is Congressional Resolution Number 22-140 for adoption. CR Number 22-140 is a resolution expressing the sincere condolences and sadness of the 22nd Congress of the Federated States of Micronesia to the family of the late President Jacob Nena at his passing on July 6, 2022 at the age of 80.
Okay, Chairman Willick. Chairman Mone. Motion for adoption. Motion for adoption. Resolution.
So moved.
Second. Second.
It's been moved and seconded that Congress adopt resolution number 22-140. Okay, this is the condolence resolution for the late President Nena. As you know, we are trying to put in some assistance, small, but at least from Congress, we should show the family that we also care about one of our presidents, late presidents. So I hope we can continue to support that in the supplemental. Okay, any further discussion?
Speaker.
Yes.
Thank you very much, Mr. Speaker. This is an individual that for some unknown psychological reason I came very attached to. We seem to be usually talking from the same frequency and same wavelength. But one thing I recall about the individual, I still owe him for a promise that I had made to him when we were debating whether the fisheries project was going to work. And I assured the individual that he needed to help because it was going to work. And this was one of James Movic's proposal. So I told him after we had quite a lengthy debate on the merit and demerit of the project, I share with a good senator that if it didn't work, he could kick me, you know where. And he said, "Are you sure you can?" I said, "Yes." So he never had the chance, of, even though he had come back and we worked for a while together before he retired from politics. So I feel when I heard about his passing, I was sad that I had owed him the kicking or for him to kick me, but never had the chance to do that. Jacob Nena is one person that also a very good Christian, one that is fun to travel with, including one time we were in Hawaii and he poured a glass of wine on our colleague Peter Christian's head. And I knew then Pete was very, very upset, and Jacob just laughed it off, and then we all laughed, and that was the end of it. So, again, my condolences to the family, and I thank you, Speaker, with your leadership, that we were able to provide something to soften the landing of the family of the good late President Lennon. Thank you very much.
Thank you, President Orsimon, for that statement, reminiscence on what sometimes happened between colleagues and friends. Okay, so any further discussion? If not, without objection,
Speaker.
Oh, what's that? Yes, Vice Chairman Palik.
Sorry. Thank you very much, Speaker. I'm sorry. I wanted to also express a couple points and my sentiment on this resolution. First of all, I want to thank you, Speaker, and members, including Chairman Willie, thanking you for your generosity in proposing assistance to the family. But the resolution is pretty straightforward. Jacob Nina was a father to this nation, one of our former presidents. He was a father to Kosrae State, was first governor of the state of Kosrae, and has tremendous contribution to put Kosrae State and the nation. So I join all of you in thanking him for his services and contributions to our nation. Truly, he was very active in the community, members of the church leadership. I know he's a deacon in our church and was active throughout his life, both in the community and church activities in Kosrae. So again, I join all of you in extending our condolences, and also on behalf of the leadership and the people of Kosrae State, to thank Congress for passing this resolution and for your kind and generous assistance to the family. Thank you very much, Mr. Speaker.
Thank you, Vice Chairman Palik, for okay, any further discussion? If none, without objection, discussion is closed. We'll vote. Those in favor of the adoption of resolution number 22-140, say aye.
Aye.
Motion carried. Resolution 140 is adopted by Congress. Okay, next resolution, Chipper.
Mr. Speaker, as of now, we do not have any more resolutions.
Okay, we have to go back to the bill calendar. Short recess, subject to call of the chair. I know. regular order. We're now on the standing committee reports. Do we have any, Chiefer?
Mr. Speaker, again, for more reports, we have an awaiting list number 22-26 for standing committee reports awaiting the 24 hours requirement.
Okay, we'll give the chairs to figure out what to do. Next item is special committee reports. Do we have any?
As of now, we do not have any special committee reports, Mr. Speaker.
Okay, next item.
Item number 17 for assignment of measures and communications. Please refer to referral sheet number 22-82.
Okay, Chairman and members of the committees, take a look at that for your planning purposes. Next item.
Under item number 18, unfinished business, none, Mr. Speaker.
Okay, next item is bill calendar. Okay, first bill, defer.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. The first bill is on Congressional Bill number 22-218 for second and final reading. CB number 22-218 is a bill for an act to further amend sections 1, 3, and 8 of Public Law number 22-42, as amended by Public Laws numbers 22-60, 22-80, and 22-103 to appropriate $850,000 from the General Fund of the Federated States of Micronesia for the fiscal year ending September 30, 2022, to provide supplemental funding for the operations of the legislative branch of the national government of the Federated States of Micronesia and grants, subsidies, and contributions, and for other purposes.
Okay, Chairman Figuer.
Move for the passage of the bill on second and final reading.
Okay, it's been moved and seconded that Congress pass on second and final reading, CP number 22-218. Discussion.
Speaker.
Yes, sir. Chairman Smith.
Thank you very much, Mr. Speaker. I believe I have a very short amendment that I wish to make on this bill. It's been printed and distributed to our members, so I shall move for its adoption.
Okay, and second?
Again.
It has been moved and seconded that the proposed for amendment to CP 22-218 by Chairman Orismo be adopted. Short recess. Is it short or long? Congress is back in session. There's a motion for adoption of the, was seconded for the adoption of the for amendment to CP 22-218 by Chairman Orismo. And I think the thing is short enough. We can have Chief Clerk read it. But before we do that, acting floor.
Sure. I shall move that the relevant rule that may impede our action on this, especially the one on substantive amendment on second reading, be suspended.
Again.
It has been moved and seconded that the relevant rules, specifically the rules prohibiting substantive amendments on second and final reading, be suspended. Those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Motion carried. The relevant rules are now suspended. Right. So, Keeper, read into the record.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. We now have a floor amendment to Congressional Bill number 22-218, offered by Senator Joseph J. Uruzumal. Item 1, page 3, line 17, delete the figure 3,090,000 and insert the figure 2,810,000 in lieu thereof. Item 2, page 4, line 6, delete the figure 420,000 and insert the figure 380,000 in lieu thereof. Item 3, page 4, line 9, delete the figure 440,000 and insert the figure 400,000 in lieu thereof. Item 4, page 4, line 12, delete the figure 840,000 and insert the figure 760,000 in lieu thereof. Item 5, page 4, line 15, delete 880,000 and insert the figure 800,000 in lieu thereof. Item 6, page 4, line 18, delete 1,270,000 and insert 1,150,000 in lieu thereof. Item 7, page 4, line 21, delete the figure 1,320,000 and insert the figure 1,200,000 in lieu thereof. Item 8, page 4, line 24, delete the figure 415,000 and insert the figure 375,000 in lieu thereof. Item 9, page 5, line 2, delete the figure 450,000 and insert the figure 430,000 in lieu thereof. Item 10, the titles and subtotals shall be adjusted accordingly.
Okay, there you have it. Discussion on the
Speaker, I shall move for the adoption.
Okay, that's any second?
And
there is no second.
Second.
Bill has been moved and seconded that the offer for amendment to CP22-218 by Chairman Norris-Mull be adopted. Discussion.
I know discussion on Stuart, the offer, the message at the end of amendment the... By thank you, Mr. Speaker. The the purpose of the amendment is to reduce the delegation delegation representation funds from supplemental from 50 to 30 each member. Thank you.
So that's the explanation. Any discussion on the explanation?
Question
has been called for. If there is no objection, discussion is closed. We will vote. Those in favor of the adoption of the offered for amendment by Chairman Wisimo, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed?
Oh.
I'm sorry, Chairman Wisimo, you got outvoted.
Speaker.
So the proposed for amendment is not adopted. Okay, quiet. Yes.
I move that we do by roll call of the members.
Okay, there's a request to do by roll call. So roll call, Chief Clerk, on the proposed floor amendment by Chairman Ursimo.
Senator Aritos?
No.
Senator Christian? Senator Figuer?
Yes.
Senator Colon?
Very big. No.
Floor Leader Harper? Senator Conman?
Yes.
Vice Speaker Moses?
Aye.
Senator Neth? Senator Palik?
Yes.
Senator Perman?
Yes.
Senator Romulo?
No.
Senator Uruzumal?
Come on, yes.
Senator Wali? Senator Wali?
No.
Speaker Simina?
What's the food now? I got lost count. Short reasons. No, I want to know what's the food count. Food is yes or no? No, which one is no?
Speaker.
No, that's to the amendment.
Speaker.
No means yes.
Yes. Who's that? We're in session now.
Speaker. Yes.
Colin. Go ahead.
Those vote yes is how many, Chief Clerk?
As of now, seven, Chairman Colin.
And no?
Four.
No, you're wrong. Seven, no, four, yes.
Short reasons.
Yes means yes, yes to the.
Congress is back in session, so announce the result, Chief Clerk.
Sorry, Mr. Speaker, the vote is, we have a total of seven yeses and five noes.
For that reason, the proposed floor amendment by Chairman Rusinal is adopted. Okay, we have CD1. Okay, continue discussion on the bill. I have a proposed amendment. Chairman Perman, can you offer it? That's for all the other, that's for your 1 million. What are you saying?
No. I'm short recess, Speaker.
Short recess. We call the chair. Congress is back in session. We're still discussing CP22-218CT1.
Yes, Speaker.
Chairman Berman, yes.
Thank you, Speaker. I have a floor amendment by offered by Speaker. I will be offering by on behalf of Speaker Simenon. It's quite lengthy, so I ask that the reading will be dispensed with. I so move for its adoption.
Second.
It has been moved and seconded that the offer for amendment to CP22-218 by Speaker Simenon be adopted. Because of its length, we will dispense with its reading and the relevant rules are still suspended. Any discussion? Discussion.
Speaker.
Yes. Chairman Panik.
Yeah, thank you very much, Speaker. If I may not be out of order, may I make a very minor oral amendment to this floor amendment on page six.
On you page six.
Thank you. Thank you, Speaker. And that's on page six. Under item number four. The language, let me read here. Provided that the 300,000 a portion for the state of Kosrae shall be exclusively used as matching. Delete the word shall and insert may.
Okay.
And then delete the word exclusively. Just take out that word. So it will read may be used as matching.
Take note, LC. What are you thinking about? Take note of that.
So I move, Mr. Speaker.
Okay, and second. It's been moved and seconded that the offered oral amendment by Vice Chairman Palik be adopted. It is now for discussion. Any discussion on that? If none, without objection, discussion is closed. Let's vote. Those in favor of adoption of the offered oral amendment by Vice Chairman Palik, say aye.
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 Motion carried. Okay, the oral amendment is adopted. We continue discussing the offered oral amendment as orally amended. Any further discussion? If none, without objection, discussion is closed. We will vote. Those in favor of the adoption of the oral amendment as orally amended, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, nay. Motion carried. The offered floor amendment as orally amended is adopted. We now have CD2. Any further discussion on CD2? Discussion? If none, there is no objection. Discussion is closed. We will vote by roll call of the delegations. Chief Kirk.
For the state of Juke, Chairman Arutos.
I yield to Chairman Romulo.
Chairman Romulo.
No.
No.
For the state of Pompeii, Chairman Perman.
Yes.
For the state of Kosciay, Chairman Wali.
Yes.
For the state of Yap, Chairman Urusumal.
I yield to Chairman of Mani. Chairman Figuer.
For the state of Yap, Chairman Figuer.
No.
Okay, so 2-2.
What do you guys want?
Chairman, short recess.
Short recess. Chief Clerk, can you please just redo the roll call of the votes, the delegations, to be very clear?
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. For the state of Juke, Chairman from Arutos?
No.
For the state of Pompeii, Chairman Perman?
Yes.
For the state of Kosciay, Chairman Wali?
Yes.
For the state of Yap, Chairman Figuer, Chairman Urusumal.
Go ahead. Yeah, Chairman Figuer will cast the vote. No.
Chairman Figuer, for the state of Yap.
No. Yes.
Mr. Speaker, we have three affirmative votes for the said bill under second reading and one no.
For that reason, CB number 22-218 CD2 has passed Congress on second and final reading. Next bill.
Mr. Speaker.
Yes.
May I be excused for maybe
5 to 8 minutes.
I think we still have members, yeah, for second reading. Yes, you may be excused.
I'll be quick.
Yes, okay. Go ahead, next bill.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Currently under the bill calendar now is Congressional Bill number 22-219 for second and final reading. CB number 22-219 is a bill for an act to further amend public law number 20-178 as amended by public laws numbers 21-01, 21-07, 21-36, 21-53, 21-56, 21-102, 21-115, 21-137, 21-165, 21-178, 21-200, 21-218, 21-226, 21-249, 22-27, 22-63, 22-73, 22-82, and 22-138, by amending sections 5 and 6 thereof, to change the use and allotment of funds previously appropriated therein to fund public projects and social programs for the people of Chuuk State and for other purposes.
Move for the passage of the bill on second and final reading.
It's been moved and seconded that Congress pass on second and final reading, CP number 22-219. Okay, discussion on the bill. Any discussion? If none, without objection, discussion is closed. We will vote by roll call of the delegations.
For the state of Chuuk, Chairman Aritas.
Yes.
For the state of Phonpei, Chairman Perman.
Yes.
State of Kosciuszko, Chairman Wali.
Yes.
State of Yap, Chairman Urusamal.
Yes.
Mr. Speaker, all four states voted for the said bill under second and final reading.
CP number 22-219 has passed conference on second and final reading. Next bill.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. The next bill under the bill calendar now is Congressional Bill number 22-229 for second and final reading. CB number 22-229 is a bill for an act to further amend public law number 22-86. As amended by public laws numbers 22-101, 22-102, 22-106, and 22-140, by amending section 5 thereof, to change the use of funds previously appropriated therein for the purpose of funding priority infrastructure projects and other public projects and social programs for the people of Chuuk State and for other purposes.
Okay, Chairman Figuer.
Move for the passage of the bill on second and final reading.
Second. It's been moved and seconded that Congress pass on second and final reading, CP number 22-219. Discussion. Any discussion? If none, without objection, discussion is closed. We will vote by roll of the delegations. Chief Clerk.
For the state of Chuuk, Chairman Aritas.
Yes.
State of Phonpei, Chairman Perman.
Amen.
State of Kosciuszko, Chairman Wali.
Yes.
State of Yap, Chairman Urusamal.
Amen.
Mr. Speaker, all four states voted for the said bill under second and final reading.
CP number 22-229 has passed conference on second and final reading. Next bill.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Currently under the bill calendar now is Congressional Bill number 22-230 for second and final reading. CB number 22-230 is a bill for an act to further amend public law number 21-180 as amended by public laws numbers 21-191, 21-234, 21-240, 22-20, 22-39 and 22-131, by amending section 5 thereof to change the use of funds previously appropriated therein for the purpose of funding public projects and social programs for the people of Chuuk State and for other purposes.
Chairman Figuer.
Move for the passage of the bill on second and final reading.
Second.
It's been moved and seconded that Congress pass on second and final reading, CP number 22-230. Any discussion? Discussion, if none, without objection, discussion is closed. We will vote by roll call of the delegations.
For the state of Chuuk, Chairman Arutos.
Yes.
State of Pohnpei, Chairman Perman.
Amen.
State of Kosciay, Chairman Wali.
Yes.
State of Yap, Chairman Urusamal.
Hey.
Mr. Speaker, all four states voted for the said bill under second and final reading.
CP number 22-230 has passed Congress on second and final reading. Next bill.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. The next bill we now have under the bill calendar is Congressional Bill number 22-231 for second and final reading. CB number 22-231 is a bill for an act to further amend public law number 21-43, as amended by public laws numbers 21-54, 21-71, 21-82, 21-103, 21-107, 21-158, 21-186, 21-235, 22-16, 22-50, 22-68, and 22-123, by amending section 5 thereof to change the use of funds previously appropriated therein to fund public projects and social programs for the people of Chuuk State and for other purposes.
Okay.
Move for the passage of the bill on second and final reading.
Second.
It's been moved and seconded that Congress pass on second and final reading, CP number 22-231. Okay, discussion. Any discussion?
Speaker. Speaker.
Yes, who's that? Chairman Romano?
Yes, thank you, Mr. Speaker. I have an oral amendment to that bill. And on page 5, line 7, delete the amount and insert 5,000 in lieu thereof. On page 5, line 14, delete the amount 5,000 and insert a zero in lieu thereof. So I'll move, Mr. Speaker.
Second.
It has been moved and seconded that the offered oral amendments to CP 22-231 by Chairman Romulo be adopted. The relevant rules are still suspended. So discussion on the offered oral amendments. Discussion, if none, without objection, discussion is closed. Let's vote. Those in favor of the offered oral amendments to CP 22-231 say aye.
Aye.
Motion carried. The offered oral amendments are adopted. We now have CT1. Any further discussion on CT1? Discussion. If none, without objection, discussion is closed. We will vote by roll call of the delegations.
For the state of Chuuk, Chairman Arutos.
Yes.
State of Pohnpei, Chairman Perman.
Hey, mine.
State of Kosciay, Chairman Wali.
Yes.
State of Yap, Chairman Urusamal.
Thank you, Chief Clerk, yes.
Mr. Speaker, all four states voted for the said bill under second and final reading.
Okay, CB number 22-231 CD1 has passed Congress on second and final reading. Next bill.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Under the bill calendar now is Congressional Bill number 22-147 CD1. This is attached to Standing Committee Report number 22-38. CP number 22-147 CD1 is for first reading. CB number 22-147 CD1 is a bill for an act to amend section 205 of Title 52 of the Code of the Federated States of Micronesia, annotated, as amended by Public Law number 21-237 and Public Law number 21-245 for the purpose of increasing the base salary schedule of FSM national government employees and for other purposes.
Okay, Chairman Donald.
Move for adoption of the said bill.
Second.
It's been moved and seconded that Congress pass on first reading, CP number 22-147. Okay, discussion. Short recess. look for nine. It's a Congress is back in session. We're now discussing CP number 22-147. Okay, discussion, Vice Speaker Moses.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. This bill is very significant and very important. And I feel in light of circumstances that have arisen due to certain decisions made by a political body that is now up to the people to decide. I do not want to base my decision on this bill based on that, but I would like to see and ask if the chairman of JN Go can do a oversight and include what if this referendum passed, how will it look to us and if we can handle it? Just like they answered us before that proposed amendment was raised. And Mr. Speaker, I understand that one of our staff is feeling kind of under the weather, and with the circumstances Ponte is facing now, I would hope that we would let her go to get tested and maybe get some treatment and maybe some rest. So if I move that we adjourn sine die so that we may come together next session and address this bill, I so move that Congress adjourn sine die.
Second. It's been moved and seconded that Congress adjourn sine die.
Short recess.
I'll give you a short recess. Short recess. Back in session. Let's vote those in favor that this Congress adjourn sine die. Say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Motion carried. The fifth special session of the 22nd Congress is now adjourned sine die. Okay. Sorry.